Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about taper turning as well as knurling operation in a lathe machining operations. So first we need to understand what is a taper turning, what is its importance, what are the different methods we follow in taper turning. The first one is taper turning. A taper turning is nothing but generating a conical surfaces on a cylindrical surface. For example, if you can see a dead center of a tailstock, you can see an external taper cut on the end of a tailstock, dead center. This is in order to done for the gripping purpose at a tailstock spindle. So whenever the internal taper of a tailstock spindle, it fits into the external taper of the dead stock, it going to create a firm lock where it is very difficult to remove the dead center from the tailstock spindle. So taper turning is done in order to provide a simple lock for any two mating surfaces. So that's about a taper turning. So there are different methods of taper turning. There are five different methods. One is the broad-nose tool method, swept length compound-nose method, tailstock set-over method, taper turning attachment method, and combination of longitudinal and transverse feed movement. So let us understand by step by step what are the different methods and their importance. In a broad-nose tool method, we are going to grind the cutting tool to the taper angle itself. Then we directly are going to just feed the cutting tool, or by giving the depth of cut, we can obtain the taper. But the disadvantage is the width of the taper what we are going to obtain is very minimal at this particular case. The second one is the most common type of taper turning, that is the swivelling the compound-nose method, which we are going to discuss in a short while. The next one is a tailstock set-over method. The tailstock set-over method is used to turn a taper of smaller angles but for the longer lengths. The next one is the taper turning attachment method. A separate attachment will be fixed in order to turn a taper. The last one is a combination of longitudinal as well as transverse speed movement. So the various cutting tool will be fed longitudinally as well as depth will be given at an instantaneously together so that we can able to turn a taper. Now only an expert machinist can able to provide can generate a taper by using the combination of longitudinal and transverse speed movement. So today we are going to discuss about the swiveling of the compound method, which is most common and widely used in turning the taper. So this is the taper turning dimensions which we need to generate. Where is the larger end will be having 23 mm side, the smaller side will have 18 mm diameter, and length of the taper is given as 30 mm. So first important thing is that we need to understand what is the taper angle for that. So we want to calculate half taper angle, because whenever a workpiece is revolved between the two centers, the cutting will be fed in one particular direction. So that's why we have to calculate the half taper angle. The formula which has been used for half taper angle is alpha is equal to tan inverse of d minus 2l, where d is the larger diameter, small d is the minor diameter, and l is the length of the taper. So if you substitute the values and you want to get approximately 4.76 degrees as a taper angle, approximately it is very closer to 5 degrees. So whenever you want to machine it, the cutting tool will be set to at an angle of 5 degrees using the swiveling the compounders. So here what we need to do is the compounders rest over the saddle, wherein the cutting tool will be the compounders will be swiveled at an angle of 5 degrees by using the two nuts provided at the either end of the compounders. Then by tabling at an angle of 5 degrees, you are going to fix the cutting tool, and feed will be given by moving the compound slide only. This is the most important factor, where the cutting tool should not be fed by moving the longitudinal feed. The longitudinal feed will be given only by rotating the compound rest only. Then only we can generate the taper turning. So what is the idea behind that is, the cutting tool is made parallel to, or cutting tool is made fit parallel to the taper surface. By moving like this, I can turn a taper. The angle of whatever the angle we are going to obtain, let's say it is 5 degree here, even the workpiece is compound is also set to an angle of 5 degree. Then we can obtain the parallelity between the taper surface as well as the cutting tool. Just by moving the handle of the compound slide, I can able to turn the taper. So we will have a small demonstration on how we can able to turn a taper in a short while. So before concluding this one, we also talk about the knurling operation. So importance of knurling operation, the first one, the knurling operation is done in order to create a corrugated surface on a cylindrical workpiece. So for that, a special cutting tool known as a knurling tool will be utilized. So here we are going to have 2 to 3 knurls which has been already have certain design pattern, which the same pattern will be embossed on the workpiece. So knurling is done in order to create a rough surface or a corrugated surface, a cylindrical workpiece. Thereby it will be helpful in holding the workpiece. So this is done in order to gripping the cylindrical workpieces. That's about the knurling. The important one more factor of knurling is not a machining operation. Knurling is a forming operation, wherein just whatever the pattern of the knurls are there imposed on the workpiece by applying the external pressure on a cylindrical workpiece. That's about the knurling.